Hello everyone, Xiaobi is back from Hogolytics with a new Power BI tutorial. And in this video, you will learn what rowlevel security is and how you can apply it to your Power BI reports. Please like the video and subscribe to the channel and feel free to comment your questions and I'll try to create another new video as soon as possible to answer your questions. And you can also follow me on LinkedIn, Instagram and on my personal blog to be in touch. Stay tuned. Let's see what rowlevel security is and how we can use it. Keep watching until the end of the video. Rowlevel security is a way to restrict data in your report based on the Power BI end users. It helps to filter data access at the row level for different roles, which you can define. For example, consider a company has different branches in Pacific, North America, and Europe, and each of these continents have their own teams. Therefore, we can create three different roles for each continent, and the employees in each continent only have access to the data in their area. How we can do this and how we can create these roles? Let's go to my computer screen to see what's going on. To show how row-level security works, consider we have a simple report like this, which shows the sales amount and number of customers in different regions all around the world. Our aim is to filter data for end users in different continents. So users in North America can only see the information for the United States and Canada. Users in Europe have access to the UK, France and Germany report. And users in Pacific area can see the Australian information. The first step is defining different roles for the access level to the report. So we can click on the Manage Roles under Needs of the Modeling tab. At the beginning, you can see no roles were defined. So click on Create button below the roles to create the first role. Change the name to North America. In front of the region table, you can see three dots. Click on it. Then hover your mouse on Add Filter and you can see the list of columns in that specific table which you can filter based on them. Choose Country field and in the Text Expression field you can see Power BI shows you country is equal to value. Just write United States instead of value and so in this way the role filters the data for the United States. We should add Canada as we want to filter data for North American countries. So, we should write OR symbol index by pressing Shift and backslash for 2 times and then write country is equal to Canada. Another way to write this text code is to use in operation and just write country in. Then open the curly bracket and then United States, Canada, and then close the curly bracket. The easiest way in this example is filtering the data based on continent instead of countries. So we choose the continent filter and change the value with North America. Cool! The first role was created. Now we need to create other roles for Europe and Pacific. The same, we should filter the continent by the value Europe and Pacific. Now we have all the three roles and we can filter report for different users in different continents. Let's see how the roles are working. From the Modeling tab, choose View As and then select North America. Boom! The report filtered for only the North America. We can test for Europe and Pacific continents too. Now it's the time to publish the report and see how to define a row-level security for a user. Save the Power BI file and click on the Publish button and then choose your workspace And once the report gets published, you can go to the Power BI service. In your browser, write app.powerbi.com and it will direct you to the Power BI service, which you should first log in using your username. Then go to the workspace in which you publish the report. Go to the dataset tab, and if you hover your mouse on the specific dataset, you can see three dots. Choose the security from the options in this list. You can see the name of the three rows we defined earlier. Now you can add any of the users here and add them to each of the rows you like and save. Now everything is done, and if the specific user opened the report, they can only see the report related to them. Hope you enjoyed this video. Feel free to comment your questions. Please like the video and subscribe to the channel. Follow me on LinkedIn, Instagram, and my personal blog to be in touch. Have a good day, and we'll see you in the next video.